In the tapestry of history, the lineage of Catherine, Princess of Wales, was as diverse as it was fascinating. Her ancestors, a mosaic of contrasts, spanned the breadth of the social hierarchy. The threads of her heritage included affluent mill owners and magnates of coal and wool, alongside humbler origins such as colliers, a road sweeper, and even a convict once confined within the walls of Holloway Prison. Yet within this colourful ancestry stood one figure whose life was a whirlwind of adventure and romantic tumult, overshadowing all others. Her name, Mary Eleanor Bowes. If there was a woman whose existence in Georgian England was as tumultuous as brilliant, her narrative seemed ripped from the darker, more thrilling chapters of a Jane Austen novel, where social scandal entwined with personal victory. Mary Eleanor Bowes, an heiress of considerable wealth, traced her lineage back to Sir Thomas Blakiston Conyers. This notable figure was a direct ancestor of Catherine, Princess of Wales, and the revered late Queen Mother. Mary Eleanor's life, marred by scandal, yet marked by an indomitable spirit, served as a testament to the varied and rich history that flowed in the veins of Catherine's family, painting a picture of a lineage as complex as it was compelling. In a tale as intricate as the finest lace, Mary Eleanor Bowes was born into wealth and high society on February the 24th, 1749. It unfolded with dramatic twists that belied her prestigious beginnings. She was the cherished sole offspring of Sir George Bowes, a respected member of Parliament, and his second wife, Mary. The young Mary grew up in a lap of luxury on the stunning Gibside estate in the Derwent Valley, Tyne and Wear, a place of such remarkable beauty that it captured the imagination of the famed painter Turner. Sir George, a shrewd businessman and landowner with a network of collieries under his control, nurtured his daughter's intellect. By the tender age of 4, Mary had already mastered fluent reading. Her intellectual prowess blossomed further as she developed into a gifted linguist. However, tragedy struck when she was just 11 years old. Her father passed away, but leaving her as the wealthiest heiress in Britain. Despite her enviable societal position and immense wealth, Mary's life was a cascade of controversies. She engaged in extramarital affairs, endured a series of illegal abortions, and found herself entangled in a torturous marriage with a malevolent fraudster. This man not only dominated and controlled her, but eventually kidnapped her in a desperate bid to maintain his grip when she sought freedom. Such was her tumultuous life that she earned the moniker the Unfortunate Countess. Yet Mary rose like a phoenix from the ashes of her trials. She became a distinguished botanist and a trailblazer in divorce law reform. Her enduring legacy is etched in stone at Poets' Corner in Westminster Abbey, a testament to her resilience and brilliance. The threads of Mary's family would intertwine with the noble Lyons family of Scotland, culminating in the union that produced Elizabeth Bowes-Lyon, the beloved Queen Consort to King George VI and mother to the late Queen Elizabeth II. Mary Bowes' life, marked by scandal and achievement, is crucial in the storied history of one of Britain's most renowned families. On the momentous occasion of her 18th birthday, Mary Eleanor Bowes, already a woman of substantial inheritance, entered into matrimony with John Lyon, the 9th Earl of Strathmore. The owner of the enchanting Glamis Castle, later known as the childhood sanctuary of the Queen Mother, the Earl was welcomed into a union with Mary under unique conditions. Following her father's will, designed to safeguard her substantial inheritance, her husband was required to adopt her surname, a mandate ratified by Parliament itself. This blending of names would later give rise to the esteemed Bowes-Lyon lineage. Tragically, the early years of their marriage were shadowed by illness. The Earl succumbed to tuberculosis and met his untimely demise at sea while journeying to Portugal in 1776. His death left Mary at the tender age of 27, a widow burdened with the care of their five young children. However, Mary's heart was not entirely shattered by this loss. By the time of her husband's death, she was already carrying the child of her lover, George Gray, a man who had once amassed and then squandered a fortune in the employ of the East India Company. Fearing the loss of her title, Mary was reluctant to marry Gray, and in a desperate attempt to maintain her status, she resorted to drinking a toxic concoction, a black, inky kind of medicine, to induce an abortion. The affair with Gray persisted, leading to multiple pregnancies and further abortions. When she became pregnant for the fourth time, Mary begrudgingly considered marrying Gray, but fate had another twist. Despite her engagement to Gray, she fell under the spell of a cunning adventurer named Andrew Stoney. Disguising himself as Captain Stoney, though merely a lieutenant, he orchestrated a sham duel with the editor of the Morning Post, which had been publishing defamatory articles about Mary. In a dramatic ploy, Stoney feigned a mortal wound from the duel, and in his supposed dying moments in 1777, convinced Mary to marry him. Stoney's true nature quickly surfaced. He seized control of Mary's fortune and subjected her to 8 long years of physical and mental torment. Mary's endurance finally reached its limits, and she managed a daring escape. But her ordeal was far from over. In 1785, when she sought a legal divorce, Stoney abducted her in a heinous spree of threats, violence, and abduction, dragging her through the countryside on horseback before his eventual arrest. Stoney's criminal trial resulted in a 3-year prison sentence. Mary's groundbreaking divorce case captivated 18th century London. Mary Bowes emerged not only as a survivor, but also as a legal trailblazer. She made history by becoming the first woman to secure a divorce while retaining her land and fortune, a testament again to her resilience in the face of relentless adversity. In the latter chapters of her tumultuous life, Mary Eleanor Bowes sought and found a semblance of peace. She mended bridges with her family, turning her energies towards local charitable endeavours. Beyond her societal contributions, Mary nurtured a passionate interest in botany. This was vividly reflected in the meticulously maintained hothouses at her ancestral home, the Gibside Estate, and her London abode, Stanley House, in Chelsea. Her botanical pursuits extended far beyond the English landscape. Mary commissioned a collection of exotic plants from all corners of the globe, transforming her estates into veritable sanctuaries of rare and beautiful flora. Her dedication and expertise in this field was so profound that Jessie Foote, a respected surgeon and author, lauded her as the most intelligent female botanist of the age. Despite her remarkable achievements in botany and her contributions to science, history would remember Mary more for her role as a trailblazer in divorce law than for her botanical expertise. Her life journey came to a close on April the 28th, 1800. Mary Eleanor Bowes found her final repose in Westminster Abbey, where her grave, adorned with a tombstone, is situated in the illustrious Poet's Corner. This symbol of honour in one of England's most revered sites serves as a testament to her endurance and resilience in the face of life's adversities and her intellectual pursuits and philanthropic spirit. Mary Eleanor Bowes' legacy, thus, is a complex tapestry of personal tribulation, societal impact, and a profound passion for the natural world. In the intricate web of royal lineage, the connection between Catherine, Princess of Wales, commonly known as Kate Middleton, and her ancestor Mary Bowes, the Countess of Strathmore in Kinghorn, offers a fascinating glimpse into the past. This link bridges two eras, intertwining the lives of two women from vastly different times. Mary Bowes, born in 1749, is a distant forebear to Kate Middleton. Mary's life, a tapestry of wealth, scandal, and resilience, contrasts with Kate's modern royal narrative. Mary, a wealthy heiress, endured a life marred by an abusive marriage, groundbreaking legal battles, and a passion for botany. Yet despite the adversities, she emerged as a pioneer in divorce law and an acclaimed botanist of her age. Kate Middleton, born centuries later, in 1982, entered the royal family under vastly different circumstances. Her marriage to Prince William, the eventual heir to the British throne, blended traditional royal customs and modern sensibilities. Kate's journey, unlike Mary's, has been one of relative stability and acceptance within the royal family. The connection between these two women, separated by time and circumstance, offers valuable lessons. Kate can draw inspiration from Mary Bowes' resilience and her ability to reinvent herself in adversity. And Mary's existence highlights the vital role of inner grit and dedication to one's interests, traits that echo profoundly in Kate's path as a royal. Furthermore, Mary's experiences highlight the evolution of women's roles and rights over the centuries, providing an historical context to the freedoms and responsibilities Kate experiences today. The contrast between their lives is a testament to the progress made in women's rights and societal norms. The link between Kate Middleton and Mary Bowes-Lyon is more than a mere genealogical fact. It is a reminder of the enduring strength of women across generations, the changing tides of history, and the continuous journey towards empowerment and self-fulfillment. Thank you for joining me on this journey. If you love what you saw and are eager for more, I've got just the thing waiting for you. Don't miss out on this next video featuring Georgina Cavendish, a full-length story of one of the most iconic ladies in history.